Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel, Court the Nurse Realtor, and I am Court the Nurse Realtor. If you see me in scrubs, please know that this is going to be a nurse-related video. So if you are new to my channel, hey, welcome, welcome, welcome. And if you are oldie but a goldie, hey boy, hey, hey girl, hey. I know it's oldie but goodie, but I like to say oldie but a goldie. Welcome back, welcome back. So, as you know, our world is going through a health crisis pandemic in regards to COVID-19, aka the coronavirus. So with that being said, there has been a lot of chatter in regards to travel nurses and taking contracts with all this going on. So I decided to, number one, make a video in regards to my opinion and just give some tips on if you are thinking about taking a contract during the coronavirus pandemic. So honey, if you are traveling, you like, girl, I'm finna go get my check. If you are thinking about taking a contract and you like, I don't really know, or if you want to just be plain old nosy, go ahead and stay tuned because we're gonna get into it in this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and most importantly, ring my bell. Ring my bell, my bell. Ring my bell so you can stay notified of when I post my videos. Okay, so let's just get right into it. I know that there has been like a lot of posts, a lot of text messages, a lot of chatter going around about how much is being offered for nurses to stand in a need in the places with high coronavirus cases. For instance, I've seen up to $10,000 a week to go to New York. Also in Washington State, and I'm hearing a lot of chatter about nurses getting ready to go to Louisiana as well. But I just wanted to hop on here, and because you know I love y'all and I want y'all to be informed and think of things holistically before you make any commitments when it comes to contracts. So should you be travel nursing during coronavirus? First off, I think that is a personal decision. You all know y'all personal situation. You know what you're willing to put yourself at risk for. So number one, you need to think about the risk that you are taking, okay? Make sure you understand what you are getting yourself into. When you are going to somewhere that, like New York, that is the epicenter of this coronavirus battle that's going on, you should understand that they are low on PPE, they are low on housing, and it's just basically like an hysteria or hysteria type setting. You should be ready. You should know that you might not have PPE. You will more than likely be exposed to corona, and that there are a lot of risks that you are taking by accepting these contracts. Now, if you are somebody who are you got your little stash of PPE and you ready, you want to make them checks, by all means, go ahead and do that. But if you're trying to do this as your first assignment or just to get some experience, make sure you think about what you're doing before you do it, because there is no room for being nitpicky or no room for being kind of rigid when it comes to things, because the state of nursing in New York is a whole nother ball game at this point. And I'm not just saying that because of what I'm seeing on the news. I used to be a travel nurse, and I have a lot of friends across the country, particularly two really good friends of mine who are in New York, in the epicenter, boots on the ground, and they are saying it's not even worth the money. However, that should be your decision. If you like, girl, let me get my check, I'm prepared, I got my own PPE, go get your money, sis. But be mindful that it's high stress, they have limited PPE, and it is highly contagious, and the housing situation, there is very slim to none housing to house you. So just be aware. Also, when you go to do these contracts, make sure that you're getting a crisis rate, because I'm seeing some contracts that's like $3,000 for like four. Listen, to be quite frankly honest, you could make some good money and not be at risk if you structuring your deals a different way, or structuring your contracts in a different way. Also, if you're gonna go, I would say don't sign up to do or be committed to do something for a long stretch. Like the one that's $10,000, I've seen that it's like you have to do 14 to 21 day stretch. That's a long stretch. Maybe come in at a lesser time frame, like maybe 3-12, 36 hours a week, and then pick up the overtime, and you could definitely see that money if your overtime rate is high enough. I'm looking at my notes, so if you see me look down, that's what I'm doing. Before you sign a contract, make sure you have an understanding of your float situation, your PPE situation, and your resources. Make sure you have an understanding with the nursing manager. Make sure you have an understanding with your agency. And make sure you have an understanding with you and your family. Because if you are going to be quarantined after you expose, your contract should note that you are going to get paid for quarantine. If you're not going to be getting paid when you get, if you get exposed and you have to be quarantined, don't do it, sis, because you're going to be exposed for this money, but then you're going to have to still be, you're going to be quarantined for 14 days and not getting any pay, even though you willingly exposed yourself. So make sure that you know what you're getting yourself into and make sure your contract is stating these things. You guys, make sure you're looking into your housing rates, housing as well. If you say you're picking to go to New York, you say, let me go get this money. Make sure you have somewhere to stay, because if you notice, a lot of these contracted agencies are coming up with, they're not offering housing. It's nowhere to stay, sis. If you don't have anybody that you could bunk with, or if you don't have a hotel or some type of Airbnb lined up, it's nowhere to stay. So you need to make sure that you, number one, have your crisis rate, that you have your housing locked in, and that you know once you get if you get exposed, that you are going to be paid for your quarantine time. Listen, I'm not saying that you should not do this. I think that everybody, if you can handle the stress, if you can be a helpful hand in this time of need, by all means do it. Just make an educated decision before you go. I want all my nurses out there, my healthcare professionals, my nursing students, everybody that's on the front line to, number one, stay safe. Please, please, please stay safe. Make sure you're washing your hands. And most importantly, God loves you. God bless you. I'll be praying for y'all. Talk to y'all soon.